So back to my presentation. When adjuvant and adjuvant therapy of non-small cell lung cancer remains topical, we understand that potentially resectable patients amount to approximately 30%, and really pathological free stage give us 5-year survival over 35%, while 2B pathological around 23%. In this situation, any options give us an opportunity to increase the survival of the patients, we have to help them. Clinical guidelines and the situation we have as of now mean that the decision in terms of the patient's therapy has to be multidisciplinary. You see that in accordance with clinical guidelines, adjuvant chemoradial or chemotherapy remains an obligatory option in non-advanced lung cancer. These are RUSCO guidelines dated 2018. When we speak about resectable cancer, as a separate option, we may consider induction chemotherapy with the platinum-containing doublets in case of N2, or we speak about adjuvant therapy, also using platinum. If we talk about non-radical operation or positive resection edge, we can offer chemoradial chemotherapy or radiotherapy to the patient. We are considering two approaches: adjuvant chemotherapy. This method of therapy, there was a great interest to it back in 1980s, 1990s, and the main trials were conducted at the end of the 20th century and the first decade of the 21st century. Meta-analysis was one of the main analyses. It included a lot of trials and covered almost 5,000 patients and provided us with the information how adjuvant therapy may impact overall survival and progression-free survival. The decrease of the mortality risk decreases by 11%, overall survival, 5-year survival is increased by 5%. Progression-free survival, 5 years, amounts to almost 6%. It seems very important to me in this meta-analysis, the efficacy of adjuvant therapy depending on the stage of the disease. The maximum profit is received by the patients with second and third stage. As for the first patients, we'll discuss them a little bit later. Patients with the first stage have no effect from the adjuvant therapy. Another important study here and discuss whether their therapeutic effect is unused in the course of time. The results were very good. With the course of time, the effect of the adjuvant chemotherapy was preserved in the patients with second stage. Profit from this therapy. Patients with this stage, when is it worthwhile to carry out adjuvant chemotherapy for patients with first B? Sub-analysis allowed us to state that only in the situation when the size of the tumor exceeds 4 centimeters, it is worthwhile to carry out adjuvant chemotherapy.
very important question for the oncologist is whether it is worthwhile to treat older people. Doesn't it increase the risks for them? Sub-analysis carried out in BR2 trial shows that patients of 65 years and higher may be treated, and the effects will be good. No increase in toxicity, but patients over 75 years and over 70 years always push us to define risks and benefits. And the adjuvant therapy selection for this group is certainly at the discretion of the doctor, but more no than yes. Neoadjuvant chemotherapy. There are some prerequisites for neoadjuvant therapy. We understand that the disease is of systemic nature on early stage, pre op locally regional site reduction with the help of medicines is a good option. As a rule, pre-op therapy is better tolerated by the patient, and thus adequate doses may be selected in pre-op period. Several studies I want to draw your attention to. This is quite an old work. Neoadjuvant chemotherapy was assessed in third stage non-small cell lung cancer, 7 years follow-up. Chemotherapy and further surgery, first diagram, 12 months median survival, only surgery, much less. Another meta-analysis, neoadjuvant chemotherapy and surgery, or just surgery. The data vary. Some trials show the benefits of the neoadjuvant regimen, but some trials don't show any benefits. Thus, this method is indicated to a specific cohort of patients. Taking this into account, we may say yes. We may provide profit for a certain group of patients by this pre-op neoadjuvant chemotherapy. Pre-op radiotherapy or chemotherapy. You see, both options have a right to exist. And the efficacy of these two methods is comparable. What is to be preferred, adjuvant or neoadjuvant chemotherapy? Not study, answer this question. NEDGE study. It had 3 arms, neoadjuvant therapy, surgery only, and adjuvant therapy after surgery. The efficacy of both neo and neoadjuvant and adjuvant therapy was comparable, more than 6%, and thus it is a doctor who has to decide which regimen to offer, adjuvant or neoadjuvant. As of now, standard approach is to earlier non-small cell lung cancer are as follows. When we have high risk of progression and large tumors, we offer adjuvant chemotherapy, understanding that third grade adverse events and higher will be very frequent. Adjuvant and neoadjuvant therapies have the same efficacy. What can improve the standards of these approaches? We live in the era of checkpoint inhibitors, and immunotherapy in the segment of adjuvant and neoadjuvant
format.
May show very interesting results. The predictors of checkpoint inhibitors effect is very important. PD-L1 status is a cornerstone here. The prognostic importance of this parameter is very high. And this is the basis for choosing checkpoint inhibitors in early lung cancer. Another interesting marker is tumor mutation burden. This sub-analysis seemed of great interest to me because it was based on the results of LACE meta-analysis that was performed in the late 90s. The mutation burden impacts everything, including the cisplatin efficacy. It is evident that mutation burden is associated with pathomorphologic response to neoadjuvant therapy. Nivolumab was used in this study, and you see that this parameter is a very clear predictor of a response to therapy. Another interesting aspect is combined prescription of checkpoint inhibitors, and there are good prerequisites. We know that the study that demonstrated two adjuvant administrations of Nivo, although the cohort of patients was not large, around 30 patients, and we remember that 9 patients received achieved full pathomorphological regression of the tumor. Combined prescription of checkpoint inhibitors, it is considered has to be of greater effect, and we see this. The results of this trial were presented at ASCO 2019. The number of complications, periop, or mortality have not increased. A lot of trials are being carried out with the use of checkpoint inhibitors as an option of adjuvant therapy. Nivolumab, pembrolizumab, atezolizumab, atezolizumab plus chemotherapy, durvalumab, etc. In the near 5 years, we'll definitely see very precise therapeutic options that we would be able to recommend to patients. For some patients, around 25% have activating mutations, and this envisages the use of tyrosine kinase inhibitors as an option for adjuvant and neoadjuvant therapy. Please, we have to stick to the agenda. I have only 3 slides left. The radiant study that showed the improvement of progression-free survival, but no improvement of overall survival. And the CITONG progression-free survival improved, overall survival not. Current trials of target therapy, adjuvant and neoadjuvant, lots of them, but we are waiting for the results still. Summing up, adjuvant chemotherapy is recommended to patients with non-small cell lung cancer, second, third stage. May be considered for the patients of tumors over 4 centimeters, but 1B stage. It is important for the chemotherapy to be started 8 to 10 weeks after the operation. 4 cycles of doublets based on platinum have to be used. Neoadjuvant chemotherapy is prescribed in the case when surgeries on the question, adjuvant target and immunotherapy are being studied further, but we don't have final data.